some people are attracted towards meditation and automatically all these things drops. That is beautiful. There are some people out of laziness, they neither do this nor do that. That is dangerous. If you are meditating, because you are meditating, if all these things drops, it's beautiful. You have graduated. But you neither do meditation nor do this type of things, then it's something seriously wrong. Do the colors denote anything in the 7-layer chart? No, no, no. It is just to show you the difference that 7 colors are used. That's nothing like that. That's not even designed by me. Some of my disciples has designed it. Here is a nice question. Beloved Swamiji, if Hinduism is all encompassing and all embracing, how do we explain the plight of the untouchables? Would you raise your beautiful voice to make their lives more meaningful? You may say they chose to be born as such, but do you think the consciousness of the more higher caste needs to be addressed so we are able to eradicate the hostility towards untouchables? Beautiful questions. Untouchables. I am just dead against this idea of untouchability. And all our system, our temples, or in our whole system, I never even inquire about, I don't even know about the caste or community. We don't even bother about it. We neither ask nor bother. I think I do not know about any other organizations. In our organization, in our main headquarters itself, I allow everybody to touch our Anandeshwara, the main ashram deity, and do puja. I neither bother about their caste nor bother about their community. Second thing, I allow even women to touch all the 365 days. All the 365 days, I let them touch Anandeshwara. I don't feel they are somewhere low at the time of periods. I am very clear, it is just a physical thing. I am not interested in forcing my understanding on other temples. But I believe I execute it. You see, at that time of periods, your mind and body is in low mood. You need more God, more meditation, more help. How can you be kept away? If God cannot help you when you need, what is the need for Him? So according to me, you need more meditation, more God, even at those moments. So I let people to touch. I let people to do puja, do meditation, everything. So I have no problem of this side, as far as women concerned, and the same way, untouchable. I have spoken about this caste system elaborately in a discourse called Indian Community System, in Gita discourse. Why it is created, where we missed, and how we can again use the system properly. Why it is created, how we missed it, how we can use the system again in a clear way. I have spoken about this elaborately more than 2.5 hours in the Indian Community System. Try to listen to the DVD. That can give you a clear idea. Now I won't be able to repeat the whole thing. Once more, we have no time. In Gita discourse, I think 11th day, see the Indian Community System title. Yes.
I want to know if you give Diksha 7th day.
Of course.
I would like to have one.
Yes.
Swami 7th day.
7th day. Indian Community System. You spoke about that. Please listen. Oh, yeah, again, Sabine, I'll answer this later on. It's a personal question. Any personal questions, I'll answer later on. In the time of energy session, you can ask me. But the questions which is related to everybody, I'll answer those questions here. Oh, here is the person. Swamiji, can I take your picture? You are, maybe we can have a group photo. Group photo, or we can have a few minutes separately. That time we can have. Please do not take photograph or videography at the time of energy darshan or any program. Because it, we made it as a policy. You can take photograph with me later on outside the class. In pranic meditation after exhaling, I experienced a state of perfection and could feel bliss for 2-3 seconds. This was after exhalation was over and lungs empty. Then immediately the suffocation to inhale again followed, and this feeling of bliss awareness continued for 3-4 times in that meditation. How should I try to repeat this experience? Or just ignore it. Ignore it, it will happen again and again. If you try to repeat, your very trying will destroy the whole beauty of that experience. Beautiful means you have a conscious glimpse. This conscious glimpse, once or twice also, is beautiful. It will give you the inspiration to again and again meditate. That's nice. Here is a question I already answered in yesterday's discourse itself, the last discourse. There are some healing questions you can ask me at the time of energy darshan, last session. Can we do meditation in Vajrasana rather than half Padmasana? Oh, Ardha Padmasana. Yes, we can do it in Vajrasana also, no problem. But usually Ardha Padmasana will be more solid, stable. I have been practicing TM according to Maharishi Mahesh Yogi. How can I incorporate the technique I learned here? These, my techniques are not contradictory with any other system. They are only complementary. So you can imbibe these techniques also in your life. You will only feel more alive and fresh, rejuvenated. Swamiji, during meditation last night, like a drop into my lap, I understood a universal truth concept. It was complex, yet completely simple. Coming out into the denser bodies, I could not hold on to the concept, but only the profound memory of the experience. What can I do to bring these concepts into my conscious memory when I exit the meditation? Do not bother. The very experience will start working on you. You do not try to do anything. You try one, you put your effort only on the techniques. Let everything else happen. And when some experience happens, do not stop or try to hold that. Again and again, you put your effort only in witnessing and meditation. That experience will automatically get more and more deepened. If you turn your attention towards the experience, it will just not only disappear, you will also miss the path. You will get down in between some city thinking that it is Delhi. Do not, never ever bother about any experience. I tell you, people who are caught in the experience, they become egoistic and they start thinking that they became enlightened. Never ever caught in any experience. Ramakrishna says beautifully. It's like one guy is a hunter. He goes to the forest to hunt. Suddenly one sadhu appears and says, go in. This guy goes in, he finds the sandalwood forest. Gets the sandalwood and sells, he becomes a rich guy. And again, next day the sadhu appears and says, go a little more in. He goes inside and sees a copper mine. Brings the copper and sells. Again after a few days, the sadhu appears and says, go in. He finds a silver mine. Brings the silver out. Again the sadhu appears and says, go in. he finds gold mine. So go in. That is the only word. So never bother about this small, small experience, this beautiful experience, this wonderful thing. Again, you have the conscious glimpse of the satya, truth, and you will feel, oh God, the whole puzzle, the zigzag puzzle will fall in line. That's what happens. Who is the questioner? The questioner chair right now. Nice, beautiful. You really had a clarity or understanding. That's nice. But do not stop with this. Work, put your effort only on techniques. Then automatically things will happen. What's the difference between moksha and enlightenment? Moksha, enlightenment, nirvana, atmanyana, brahmanyana, sakshatkara, sakdarshana, atmadarshana, all same experience, different trademark, that's all. Each one has got their own trademark, that's all. Otherwise, all same experience. Which of the meditation techniques should I practice after I am done with the class? Who is the questioner? Are you going to take healing initiation?
No.
No. Then do Mahamantra. In the LVP, do that Mahamantra. If you are going to take healer's initiation, in the healer's initiation, you will be given a technique to practice the whole day. Whole day is not even a technique, it's just a falling into that state. What Raman Maharshi calls as Atma Spurana. I call it as Ananda Spurana. So, you will be taught how to fall in that same level. But the problem is, if you are continuously doing that meditation, you have to be vegetarian and you should not take alcohol. If you can take that vow of no alcohol and no non-veg food, you can take the healing initiation. That will really help you. I tried to initiate people who are alcoholics or people who eat non-veg. Somehow it creates some imbalance in them. They feel uneasiness. That's why I don't give the higher level initiation for the people who are alcoholic. I'm not giving you this as a morality. After the research, I find this is the way it works. So that's the reason I have to avoid non-vegetarian. And if you can try taking healing initiation, it will do a lot, and the whole day you'll be able to stay in that same state of the boundarylessness or pure consciousness. Many people have experienced it. Dearest Swamiji, we work as a group. Are we affected by the released negative energy from our group members? No. Yeah, I am sitting here, do not bother. I take care of the whole thing. You will not be affected. And the whole group negative energy also is not even 1% of the positive energy released by enlightened master. So do not bother about it. The whole group put together. And one more thing, negativity is not so powerful as you think. All negativity has got only one power, that your faith on it, that's all. Whether it is black magic, or ghost, or evil spirit, or jyotisha, or this dosha, that dosha, kalasarpa dosha. People always tell me, kalasarpa dosha, kalasarpa dosha. See, kalasarpa dosha is nothing but being caught in the past and future. Kalasarpa means what? Past, present and future. If you are suffering between the past and future, you are having kalasarpa dosha. That's all. Kalasarpa dosha is not something like a, you will have some dosha in your horoscope. You are having some dosha in your mind. So, all these things are only your faith on it. That's all, nothing else. Always these people come and ask me, Swamiji, my brother has done a black magic on me. My sister has done a black magic on me. My mother-in-law, that is the main thing. My mother-in-law went and did some black magic for me. This mother-in-law black magic is a universal thing. My mother-in-law went and did some black magic for me. And this is a big problem. How much you tell them? 8 times I used to tell them, hey, all these things are nothing. Nobody can do black magic. Be very clear. See, understand one truth. Only an enlightened master's words will come true. If at all the curse can work, means only his curse can work. But enlightened person will never curse. He will never be able to curse. So be very clear. This, understand these two statements. Only an enlightened person's curse can work because only he has got so much of power. Cursing cannot be done by anybody and everybody. Don't think the Tom, Dick and Jerry can curse you. All these guys walking the street can curse you. That and all will not work. Only an enlightened person can curse. Only he has not that much of power. But enlightened person can never curse. Can never curse. If he is cursing, he is not an enlightened guy. So be very clear. If somebody curses, he is not enlightened. So naturally, it is not going to work. If he is enlightened, he can't curse. Naturally, there is no problem. So just forget about all this nonsense. This curse, black magic, all these things are just foolishness. When I say all these things, people think, no, he's young guy, he don't know all these things. He doesn't know about all these things. Then what to do? Early times I used to tell people, hey, don't bother, this curse and all is nothing, black magic and all is nothing. Then they started talking behind. No, he's young guy, he doesn't know all these things. We have to go to some elderly swamis. We have to go to some other shop. Then I started doing another kind of trick. I'll give some yantra, I'll give something. And I tell them, your black magic has been removed, don't worry, I'll take care. Now people feel completely secure. Nothing is there in the yantra. Simple copper sheet. But what to do? But people want only that. People want only some consolation. See, no. When you use it for meditation, it's positive energy, that is different. But it's not like you are having some black magic and I am sending opposite astra. And both go and hit him. After seeing that movies, in that Ramayana Mahabharata and all, they will show you that scene, two astras will come. One Brahmastra, another Brahmastra, tuck, it will hit each other and both will drop. People always want that type of some drama. And they want to have it. They visualize that there is some astra somebody sent. And now Nityananda Swami will send his astra. And both will go and hit each other in the street and drop. And nothing like that will happen. Be very clear, something, some foolishness they see in the TV and movie, and they start expecting the same thing to happen in the real life also. And I have seen people who come for healing also, like in Telugu, Vitalacharya movies, they expect some light will flow from my hand and the 80-year-old woman becomes suddenly 16-year-old girl. What happened to me? I have become young. They think it will become like that. What to do? This all happens only in Vitalacharya movie, not in real scene. Please do not expect this type of extraordinary things. And one more thing. And this type of all this black magic and all those things are just collective beliefs. They are called collective beliefs. It's nothing but collective beliefs. And just liberate yourself from all these things. Do not waste your time, money, energy in all these foolish things. I always insist on all these things.
What about Sai Baba producing vibhuti and...
Never ask anything mentioning any individual being. Can I practice these meditation techniques at home? Based on the notes I have taken with love and respect, you are welcome. You can practice, nothing wrong. And if you can teach it without mistake, you are free to teach also. I have no problem. Be very clear. I don't ask you to promise that it is a secret. Don't go and tell outside. All these things are just business techniques. I am not interested in doing all those business things. Only one request I have. Please do not miss any instruction. Do not add any instruction. Do not make your own technique. Transmit the technique as it is.